Welcome back guys. In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up a sensor that is BMP180. To know more this sensor, let's move on to our website controleverything.com and let's have an overall look over this sensor and search this sensor. So we have this sensor BMP180, which is a digital pressure sensor. The range of this sensor is 300 to 1100 hectopascal, and these are some of its features which you can see on my screen. You can purchase this sensor from here. Well, I will be interfacing this sensor with the Raspberry Pi, and for that I require Python code. So let's have a look over the resource tab, and this is the required Python code we need. Now to download the Python code sample, click on this and you can have the code from here. You can also have the code from our GitHub repository, that is the official repository of controleverything.com, and the name is Control Everything Community. Now you can download the code from there also. So you have two ways by which you can get the code. Its choice is yours by which either way you can get the code. So next we want to have a video tutorial, and for that we require some hardware, and let's make some connections for that. The sensor which you see on my screen is a digital pressure sensor BMP180. Now to make a further connection, we need a Raspberry Pi, which you are able to see on my screen. Now these are the GPIO pins of the Raspberry Pi. Now to make a connection among the sensor and the Raspberry Pi and a lot more other I2C devices, and to make this connection a lot easier, we need this I2C shield. This is available on our website controleverything.com, and gently press the I2C shield over the Raspberry Pi GPIO pins and make this connection. Hence we are done with the connections part, and now the binding factor to make a connection with the sensor and the shield, we need this connecting cable. Now make the connection of the cable and the sensor and make it sure that the brown wire of the cable should be connected to the ground terminal of the sensor, and same set of rules had to be applied for the I2C shield. Now our connections are done. Now we need to power up our Raspberry Pi. Hence we need a micro USB cable just like this. Gently put it over the power jack and light it up. Next, for an internet connection, there are two ways to get it done. First of all, this is an Ethernet cable. You can put it over the Ethernet jack to make an internet connection. In case if you don't have, you can go for the second way, which is a wireless USB nano adapter, which makes a lot easier your job. Hence, this is the final connections we need with all the hardware we require. Next, we need to explain and interface the code with the sensor, and let me explain the working to you. So let's proceed further. We have just completed the hardware part and the connections. Let's have a look over the interfacing of this particular sensor using a Python code, and for that we want to get the code. And so log into github.com and here search for the entity that is Control Everything Community, the official repository of controleverything.com. Now here type in BMP180, the sensor we insist, and here we go, and this is the Python code. Before proceeding further, let's have a look over the instructions for this. We have to download and install SMBus library on the Raspberry Pi, and all the steps are being provided at this link. Let's have a look over this link. As you can see, this Python module allows SMBus access through the I2C dev interface on the all Linux hosts which include Raspberry Pi also. So get over it and install it carefully. Now get back to the code, and here is our code. As you can notice, it's a .py extension file. The first thing you notice is that we have imported SMBus library on our code, and the second thing, we have imported the time library, which will give us a lot of time so that we can have a delay of some time after the writing section and after the reading part. So that's why we have imported this particular library. We have the address of our sensor, that is 0x77, and we have read data from 0xAA, that's 22 bytes. This is a data block for that. This is the conversion of that 22 byte data. As you can see, it's again a sleep so that we can have the entire conversion part smoothly. Well, in the second part, we have selected for the working conditions, and that includes the selection of measurement control register, that is 0xF4. 0x2E goes for the enabling of temperature measurement command. It's the writing part is here. Now we have read data from 0xFC and the 2 bytes are here for the temperature data, as you can see, and the conversion of this data is here as we have read continuously bytes data and for the proper values. This is according to the data sheet. Similarly, we have followed the suit for the pressure measurement. We have selected measurement control register, that is 0xFO, enabled pressure measurement OSS equal to 1, and the command for that is 0x74. The writing part is here. Now we have converted that pressure data. First of all, we have read 3 bytes of data from 0xF6. The conversion part, as you can see, is here, which is again according to the data sheet. Well, we have the calibration for temperature, calibration for pressure. This is all, as you can see. Well, the third entity is the calculation of altitude, which where we have used the pressure used in the previous formulas. As you can see, this pressure is being used here for the altitude calculation. At the very end of our screen code, we have the data for altitude, which is in meter, pressure in hectopascal, temperature in Celsius and Fahrenheit, and we have formatted it exactly to 2 places of float values. So this is a generalized code which we have used, and you can have a go through look over this entire code. So why do we use this sensor? What are the benefits, applications for this sensor? We will look forward. Now let's lay out a path for this code to be working. So first of all, copy this entire Python code. It's a bit lengthy, but let's have a look and open up the Raspberry Pi terminal here. Create a new file with BMP180.py extension and here paste the code and save it. Now this is the command to run the code, as you can notice. And here we go. It's altitude, pressure and temperature in Celsius. Now again running the command, there will be some values. Now when I apply some pressure over the sensor and send the command to read, we have the altitude, pressure and temperature and the changes value for them. Now when I again press the sensor, the value changes again. And furthermore, the altitude, pressure and temperature value changes. So this is how the Python code works this particular sensor. Now let's have a look further. As of now, we have seen the hardware connections, the explanation of the code and the working of this particular sensor, that BMP180. The BMP180 is a digital pressure sensor. It is the functional compatible successor of BMP085, a new generation of high precision digital pressure sensors for consumer applications. The ultra low power, low voltage electronics with a low altitude noise of merely 0.25 meter at fast conversion time, the BMP180 offers superior performance. The BMP180 is based on piezo resistive technology for EMC robustness, high accuracy and linearity, as well as long-term stabilities. The applications include enhancement of GPS navigation, in and outdoor navigation, leisure and supports, weather forecast, vertical velocity indication and a lot more. So we have set up a digital pressure sensor, that is BMP180. So I just thought that I would make it clear in case you are in a kind of thought that you are left without fully understanding this particular thing, the explanation, the connections or any part of this particular video. So post your queries on controleverything.com and you can post them on our community page. Now for blogs and articles which are relevant to this video tutorial, you can go to instructables.com for the communication, and to subscribe more video tutorials like this, you can subscribe our YouTube channel. Now I hope you enjoyed this video a lot and have a good one for yourself also. Thanks a lot for watching.